You are famous, some might say infamous, for meeting creators and then figuring out a way to go snooping through their analytics. What do you start looking for?
I think my focus is always audience first. I really want to figure out what makes their audience tick because everything else flows from that. So I always go in first being like, who are these people? And those are, first of all, returning viewers. So these are the people who are coming back to your channel, whether they're subscribed or not subscribed, because as we know, subscription is an activity that's less common, especially with the newer generation. So it's much better to be looking at the whole core of returning viewers. I cannot overstress how important this is. We can get very distracted by overall views. Overall views are very muddy. There's every audience mixed in there. So what I would find, and I've seen this with many, many channels, is they try a new format and they get a ton of views on it. And so they would keep doing it and keep doing it. And over time, their channel just started devolving. But when you looked and you dug in and you looked at those returning viewers, you saw that the core audience was coming in for each of those videos at lower and lower numbers. And the new viewers that did come in were a different audience and didn't return. So you could see, hey, I got a ton of new viewers, but like 2% of them actually came back.
So you work with such a wide range of channels and also with videos, like there's narrow appeal and broad appeal, core audience, casual audience, newer videos, older videos. How do you look at all those? How do you balance all of those data sets?
So the thing I really recommend is try to compare everything apples to apples. I usually use the first 7 days because it's long enough, you know, to get through the kind of what I call the core audience period where it's all your super fans coming in. So of course the metrics are going to be great because they love you and is given enough time for the algorithm to push it out far enough that you probably have a better subset of what your actual total audience, how their behavior is with your video. So it becomes much easier to compare them to each other.
And what are some of your favorite parts of analytics that you don't think people are paying enough attention to?
Our kind of cohort of like data nerds, we are all about retention. And everyone that you talk to, Renee, is going to talk about retention because it's that important. But the true power of retention comes in actually looking at those retention graphs and seeing where your audience is leaning in and what's making them say, bye, see ya, I'm never coming back. And the thing here is, unfortunately, there's nothing that replaces just time spent in the retention graphs. You cannot look at one retention graph and learn really almost anything. It has to be over time of you looking at your own retention graphs and starting to see patterns over time, which gives you the powerful insights that will help you tweak.
One of the things I've personally found interesting lately is looking at not just the retention curves, but looking at how they play out for different types of videos. For example, a video that maybe underperforms in terms of total views, but is really well embraced by my core audience will have a lower drop and a flatter line. But that doesn't really give me a lot of actionable information, where a video that massively overperforms and gets a very big casual audience is going to be just a lot lumpier. And that'll help me dig into the little details of where I really like people who aren't my fans are maybe losing interest or skipping ahead and coming back.
You give me a good video with a flat graph and I'm like, congratulations, but this is super boring to me, right? I would prefer you give me the ones that are like the highest highs and the lowest lows in the same video. And you can find some really interesting nuggets there, especially when you're starting to get into things like story structure, where it's like, hey, oftentimes there's a set of things that you do that if you put them in a certain order work. If you reorder that story structure, like suddenly it doesn't work anymore. So now you're not just learning that A, B, C, D, C, and D work. It has to be in that order A, B, C, and D. And that's the complexity you can start getting to. It's like writing a screenplay at the end of the day. You have to have that right story arc and hit those beats at the exact right point. And at the end of the day, if you just keep doing it, keep trying it, and then look at those retention graphs, you're just going to rapidly get closer and closer to that perfect story structure over time.
We have a ton more genius level guests coming your way. So hit that subscribe button and get with the contenting.